Okay, everyone, in this video, we are going to study the mixed strategy Nash equilibrium. I would say that this content here is actually the hardest content that you will study as in microeconomics. It's very complicated, but if you understand, it will also be simple. But it's take time, let's say that it takes time to clearly understand, and it's very complicated. So I want you to focus, and before you watch this video, I want you to make sure that you clearly understand all of the, the general way to find the Nash equilibrium. Before I show you how we do this, let me briefly explain first. In this in the last few videos, I mentioned that the Nash equilibrium may not exist, and we show that in the game of matching pennies, in this type of game, you don't have the pure strategy Nash equilibrium. If you can remember, we have two type of strategy: pure strategy and mixed strategy. Pure strategy is when you clearly choose to play head or play tail. You have a clear choice. You either choose head or choose tail. In other words, you may choose head with 100% possibility, and of course you choose tail with zero possibility, probability. That's what we mean by pure strategy. But what about mixed strategy? Oh, by the way, we conclude in the last slide that this game here, matching penny, in case you don't know what is matching penny, read this, okay? Read this and then continue. In this matching penny game, we don't have pure strategy Nash equilibrium, but we do have a mixed strategy Nash equilibrium. And the mixed strategy Nash equilibrium is, for example, everyone, mixed strategy means that you assign probability. So in this case, for example, Mr. A will assign 50% chance to play head and 50% chance to play tail. And it may constitute, this is what we mean by mixed strategy, okay? So mixed strategy Nash equilibrium is when both player assign this type of probability. It may be 30, 70, and for player A, for player B, and 50-50 for player A. That's fine. When you do that, when they assign, there will be some probability, everyone. There will be some probability that both player can assign into this game, into their strategy, and it will create the mixed strategy Nash equilibrium. So let's see how we solve for the mixed strategy Nash equilibrium. Everyone, before we do that, I want to just let's quickly go through the concept of Nash equilibrium. So this is when you have a pure strategy Nash equilibrium, right? You see that the Nash equilibrium is this one. Everyone, just to remind you, okay, this is the definition of a Nash equilibrium. We say that S1 and S2 is Nash equilibrium when we have the upper condition here. So S1 and S2 will be Nash equilibrium let's read this together, okay? The best response of player 1, given the strategy by player 2, is to play S1. Is to choose strategy S1. And at the same time, everyone, at the same time, the best response of player 2, given strategy of player 1, is to play S2 here. And when this condition is fulfilled, it just means that everyone is doing their best response. Okay, everyone is doing their best response function, and that means we have a Nash equilibrium. In this case of Honda and Toyota game, look here. The best response of Honda when Toyota choose to build a new plant is for Honda to build a new plant. The best response of Toyota when Honda choose to build a new plant is for, I mean, this is the best response of Toyota, right? Is for the Toyota to build a new plant. And when it is consistent, you see that it is consistent. Best response of Honda is doing their best response. Toyota is also doing their best response. So it is kind of consistent. And that's why we say that building a new plant is the Nash equilibrium for these two firms. Everyone, we also do the same. We are going to find the best response of player A and player B. Okay, and then when we get the best response, you can find the Nash equilibrium, the mixed strategy Nash equilibrium. But finding the best response is very, very hard in this case. Let's see how we do that. Everyone, first of all, in the mixed strategy, I told you before, right, that people are going to assign, the player are going to assign some probability, maybe 50 here, and of course 50 here, or 70 or 30 here. That's the example here. I'm going to say that player A, okay, listen carefully, player A will play head with probability Q. And of course, player A will play tail with probability 1 minus Q. For player B will play head with probability P and play tail with what probability 1 minus P here. Everyone, now in this case, you know that let's suppose that player B choose head. Let's suppose that player B choose head. You know that player B may get 1 or may get minus 1, right? Because this is not sure. We don't know what A will do. We know that A will play head with probability Q and play tail with probability 1 minus Q. If player B choose head, he may get this one or may get this one. He may get 1 with the probability Q, and he may get minus 1 with this probability, right? So I'm going to write this down that, look carefully, okay? The expect, maybe I should use another color. Maybe purple, okay. Expect, gain or expect payoff of player B. Look carefully, okay? Expect payoff of player B. Given, if player B choose head, if player B play head, will be equal to, you see here that if player B choose head, right? He may get 1 or minus 1, right? He may get 1 with probability 1 minus this one, or this one with probability this one. So let me maybe try to link color for you. So it will be 1 multiplied with Q here, yeah, right? He may get 1 with this probability, and he may get minus 1 with this probability. So let's write down. So it will be minus 1 with probability 1 minus Q. Okay, and that's equal to how much? Q. It just. Let's see if it, okay. It will be minus 1, is it? Nope. Sorry. It will be 2Q minus 1. Okay, 2q minus 1. 2q minus 1 is the expect payoff if player B choose to play head. Once again, okay, if player B play head, he may get 1 or minus 1. If he will get 1 with the probability Q, he will get minus 1 with this probability. So okay, I mark this here, okay, so that you can see it clearly. And then let's link this there. And everyone, this is when this is what B will get. Okay, this is what player B will get when he play head. What about if he play tail? Expect payoff of B when he play tail. This one will be equal to, you see that he will, if he play tail, everyone, he may get minus 1 or 1 here. He will get minus 1 with this probability, and he get 1 with this probability. So it will be minus 1 multiplied with Q plus 1 multiplied with 1 minus Q here. I'm going to go super slow here, okay? So, and then we expand the bracket. What you should get will be 1 minus 2Q. All right. So these two, let me shed some color for you to make it clearer. So this one, right? Maybe I should use the red color for this to make it clear. So this is Q, this is 1 minus Q. This is Q and this is 1 minus Q. All right. So this just to sum everything up. If player B choose head, this is what he will get. If player B choose tail, this is what he will get. What about player A? What about player A? You know that what about if player A choose head, what will he get? Now I'm going to write this actually the same thing. So I'm going to find the expect payoff of Mr. A given that he choose head. Everyone, if he choose head here, if he choose head here, he may get this one, right? He may get this one. Oh, sorry, let me use another color. So let's make it black, maybe. EA, right? EAH here. If he choose head, he may get minus 1 or he may get 1. We don't know, right? We don't know because we don't know what player B will. I know we don't know what player B will do. Player B will play head with probability P. So you have P percent to get minus 1. Player B will play tail with this probability. So player A will have 1 minus P percent to get 1 here when he play head. So let's write that down. Okay, so player A will get minus 1. Will get minus 1 when player B play head, and he know that player B will play head with P percent. So write down 1 here and P percent here. P percent, let me use the blue one. And of course, oh no, not 1, but it's minus 1, right? So it's minus 1. He will get minus 1 when if player B, with this chance here, with this chance. Sorry, let me change the color a bit. It's kind of complicated. Okay, so he may get this or get this. He will get this with this probability, and he will get this with this probability. So let's write that down. So it will be 1 minus 1 minus P. Sorry, 1 multiply with 1 minus P. And the answer to this will be, sorry, let me kind of I thought that it's after solving this you will get, I think it will be 1 minus 2p. That's, this is the expected payoff if player A choose head. Okay, if player A choose head, this is what he is, on average he will get this thing here. And now what about the other strategy that A can take? Let's say that is the expected payoff if player A choose tail. Okay, so okay, just oops, that's bad. Sorry, let me have a quick edition here. So this is the, and oops. Okay, everyone. So what about if player A want to play tail instead? You know that if player A will play tail, he may get 1 or -1. Once again, he may get 1 with the property p, right? And he may get -1 with the property 1 minus p. So let's write that down. It will be 1p plus -1. Okay, let me just, and then change color a bit. So this one will be 2p minus 1, right? Let me change color here. And let me just, okay, everyone, that's the expected payoff for each player. Once again, A will get this amount if player A, if player A choose to pay head, he will get this amount. If player A choose to play tail, he will get this amount. Make sure you understand this process slowly, okay? Everyone, now we have to find, now we get, this is the payoff, right? We get the payoff. Now we can find the best response. Now we want to find the best response. Okay. Let's first think about the best response of player A. Of player A. Okay, best response of player A. Everyone, you see here that player A, this guy, okay, will play head. Will play head is, will choose to play head when the gain from playing head is more than the gain from playing tail, right? He is going to choose this head when the gain, the expected gain, the expected payoff from playing head is greater than the expected payoff from playing tail. So let me write that down. That's what we mean by the best response of A, right? So everyone, let's write it this way. A will play head if the gain from playing head is greater than the gain from playing tail. Expect gain from playing head exceed the expect gain from playing tail. And that, I mean, I can just use, I can bring this condition there, right? It will be 1 minus 2p greater than 2p minus 1. And when I solve this, what I will get will be 1 over 2 p here. Okay. So everyone, if the gain from playing head, I mean for Mr. A, is greater than the gain from playing tail for Mr. A, of course Mr. A will choose to play head. And when he choose, when Mr. A, okay, listen carefully, when Mr. A choose to play head, it means that he will assign the probability of 1, or I mean 100, sorry, probability of 100% to play head. In other words, everyone, if when I say A will play head, it just means that your Q will equal to 1. You are going to play, your Q will equal to 1 when P is less than 1 over 2. Okay? Q will equal to 1 when P is less than over 1 over 2. So, everyone, but what if my psi, let's say, is kind of reversible. So let's, everyone, what if we have, what if this notation here is like this, and this one is not, this notation here become smaller than. Everyone, in this case, of course, the expect gain from playing tail is more than the expect gain from playing head, right? So we say that Mr. A will play tail if 1 over 2 is less than P here. And of course, that means your Q will equal to 0, right? When if A play tail, it means that your Q is 0, it means that this is 1. This play, if A play tail, he will the Q here, the probability that he assigned to tail will be 1. So your Q here will be 0. And lastly, what if since we don't know, right? We don't know which one will be more or which one will be less. So we have to kind of think for every possibility. And everyone, what we can do is okay, let's continue. So what if this sign is equal? So what if this P is kind of expect value between head and tail are equal, then we say that A is indifferent between head or tail. Head and tail, if P equal to 1 over 2. And in this case, we don't care. I mean, we are indifferent. We know that it does not matter what we choose, right? It does not matter we choose head. It does not matter we choose tail. If your P, listen carefully, everyone. If your P equal to 1 over 2, it means that player B will have 50% to play head and 50% to play tail. So in that case, you don't care about playing head or playing tail at all, because right now we are A, right? If B completely random his head or tail, let's say he play head 50%, he play tail 50%, you don't know what you should do at all. Okay, you don't need to worry about playing head or playing tail at all. In that case, we say that your Q will be between 0 or 1. Your Q will be between 0 or 1, okay? And that's because you can see here, we say that B have 50% to play head, B have 50% to play tail. You know that we don't have another clear way to get better than start than him, right? Because we know, we don't really know, I mean, what we will get. So we don't actually care whether we play head or we play tail. Once again, it's because the expect value are equal, okay? Everyone, this condition means that this are equal here. This expect value of playing head equal to expect value of playing tail. So that's why you are indifferent between head and tail. You kind of randomize. You don't worry about the probability. It's become 0 and 1. You don't care at all. Now that's what happened. This is the best response for player A. So just to summarize, we say that player A will play head if the gain from playing head is more than the gain from playing tail. And we derive, we kind of expand the, we solve for this, right? And then you get this condition. Everyone, this is quite simple. This is very, very clear. Let's interpret this first. When P is less than 1 over 2, when P is less than 1 over 2, it mean, what does it mean? Maybe I should write it here. It mean that player B is more likely to play, let's see, P is to play head, right? If it's less than 1 over 2, it means that B is more likely to play tail, everyone. B is more likely to play tail. And you see that in this case, if B is more likely to play tail, you are player A, right? You are player A. If player B is more likely to play tail, as a player A, you should play head. You should play head. Because player A will win if it's, if the penny does not match, right? Okay, I write this down. Win if a penny does not match, no match, no matching penny. So you see that, as I wrote here, if in this condition here, if the gain is more than, if the gain of playing head is more than the gain from playing tail, you can see that it is because B is more likely to play tail. In that case, you should play head. Because Mr. A will win when penny does not match, right? Win when no match, okay. And as I explained, B likely to play tail, then you play head. If B is more likely to play head, then you play tail, everyone. If B is more likely to play head, you play tail. And lastly, if B is equally likely to play head or tail, then you cannot, you don't know. In the end, you don't know what you should do, right? And then we say that you are indifferent between head or tail. You can simply put any possibility, any probability between 0 and 1 for head and tail. You don't care because what you do is, you cannot make yourself better off in this case. So maybe I should write this down too. So this condition means that B is more likely to play head. Okay, and that's why A should play tail. Okay. Now that's the best response of A. I'm going to conclude in this page. Okay. This is the BR for A. BR for A, for player A. We conclude that Mr. A should set Q equal to 1 when P equal to less than P is less than 1 over 2. Q equal to 0 when P is more than 1 over 2. And lastly, Q will be equal to, can be any value between 0 and 1 when P equal to 1 over 2. Everyone, this is the best response for player A. Now let's continue for player B. Now BR of B, okay, and again B win when matching, when you have a two head or when you have two tail, all right? So that's the best response of player B. We are going to do the same process as we did in this case. You will see here you say that A will play head if the expect gain from head is more than tail. So this is, everyone, this is the same. B, now we are player B, okay? Now we are player B. B will play head when the gain, this is the gain, right? This is the gain of playing head is more than the gain from playing tail. Let's write that down. B will play head when gain, expect gain from B of playing head is more than expect gain for B for playing tail, right? And we can go back and look at this. This is the expect gain, right? Expect gain from playing head is this one. Expect gain from playing tail is this one. 2Q minus 1 and 1 minus 2Q. 2Q minus 1 more than 1 minus 2Q. And when you solve this, you will see that is Q more than 1 over 2 here. Everyone, okay, so we actually do the same thing as we did before. So it will be B, we'll play tail when Q is less than 1 over 2. It's just the opposite sign, right? If this one is opposite, this one is opposite, and so you have this condition here. And of course, lastly, everyone, B is indifferent between head and tail when Q equal to 1 over 2. Everyone note that Q equal to 1 over 2, it just mean that these two are equal, okay? It mean that the expect gain from playing head equal to the expect gain from playing tail. So when you solve this thing here, you will get, you get this one, Q equal to 1 over 2. In this case, when the payoff, the expect gain are equal, you don't care about head, you don't care about tail. Alright, so we say that B is indifferent between head and tail when these are equal, when the gain are equal. And what do we mean by that? We should interpret as we did before to clearly understand. Everyone, when your Q is more than 1 over 2, what is Q again? Q is the probability that player A play head. Okay, so this one will mean that A is likely to play head, and this one is A is likely play tail. Everyone, when A is likely to play head, everyone, you see that player B will win when the coin match, right? So if player A is likely to play head, player B should also play head. And we say that for player B to play head, then it means that his P, he will assign the probability of 1 for his P here. So it just means that your P will equal to 1. Okay, this is just the interpretation. So if P equal to 1, it means that B will play head for sure. And that is because that will occur when the A is likely to play head. Okay, because if A is likely to play head, you play head as well, and so that you win from matching. And of course, if A is likely to play tail, then you should play tail as well. and we say that your p will equal to 0 here. Okay, p is the probability that b will play head. P equal to 0 is mean that b will play tail. And similarly, we have p will be between 0 and 1. You don't care at all, everyone. You don't care at all about head or tail because you cannot make yourself better off, right? When A is equally likely between head or tail, you don't know what you should do. So you also randomize. Okay, so here we just to conclude everyone, this one mean that you A is more likely to play head, so you are B, right? You are B right now, so you should play head. You set P equal to 1, which means you play head, and then of course that will mean that's your best response. This is your best response. So if A is more likely to play tail, then you should also play tail. Equal to 0 here. Okay, it means that you play tail. But if Q equal to 1 over 2, it means that A is equally likely to play head or tail. In that case, you are indifferent. You don't know what you should do at all. And now I'm going to write down my best response here. Okay, this is best response for A. So let's write down the best response for B as well. It will be something like this. So for B, is this one, right? You choose P for player B here. So what player B should do is that player B choose play head or P equal to 1. If P equal to 1, it means B play head. When he know that when Q is more than 1 over 2. This is P equal to 0 when Q is, of course, the opposite, less than 1 over 2. And P will be between 0 and 1 when Q equal to 1 over 2. Okay, just to summarize everything again. Let me write down here, P is, just to clarify, okay? P is prop that B, is it B or A? B will play head. B play head. Q is prop that A play head. So everyone, when player B is likely to play tail, then you should play head, because for A you have to not match, right? But for B you want to match the penny. And that's how you find the best response function. Okay, this is the best response function. I know that it's very difficult, but this is something that you will also use in the next topic. Not this one, okay? Not mixed strategy, Nash equilibrium, but you need to be able to write down the best response function. So once again, what do we mean this? It means that player A, this is the best response of player A, right? So this is the rule for player A, Here we say that player A will play head when player B is more likely to play tail. Player A should play tail when player B is more likely to play head. And of course, if they are equally likely, you don't care. And again, for this, it's the same. For player B, you should play head when player A is more likely to play head. You should play tail when A is more likely to play tail, because for player B, you will win when it head head or tail tail, right? And again, if it's equally likely, if you don't really know what A will do, I mean 50% A will play 50% head, 50% tail, you cannot make yourself better off, so you can randomize. You don't care about playing head or tail, you just random yourself. So it can be any value between 0 or 1. Now everyone, now the climax of this, we nearly done, okay? The climax of this, we get this best response function. The last part, everyone, is to plot this function, to plot this best response function. This is the property P, and this is the property Q again. So this is the, again, it come from this one, okay? P and Q. Now everyone, I will try to plot. Remember that P and Q is a probability, okay? P and Q are probability, so it's lie between 0 and 1. Everyone, now I'm going to draw the best response for player A and the best response for player B. For player A, you see this condition, okay? When Q equal to 1, when P less than 1 over 2. Q equal to 1 when P less than 1 over 2. When P less than 1 over 2 is this part here. When P is less than 1 over 2, you see that your Q must be equal to 1. So I write this down. That's the first line to represent this first thing here, okay? When P less than 1 over 2, you see this is 1 over 2, this is P less than 1 over 2, right? Less than 1 over 2. Your Q must be equal to 1, so it's this line. When P is more than 1 over 2, your Q equals 0. It will look like this. Okay, your P more than 1 over 2 to 1, your Q will equal to 0. And lastly, everyone, when P equal 1 over 2, P equal 1 over 2 is this line, right? P equal to 1 over 2. It is when your Q can be any value between 0 and 1. Q can be any value from 0 and 1. So what does that mean? You can just draw a line, right? Everyone, this is the best response of player A. Now, lastly, we will have to find the best response for player B. When P will equal to 1, when Q is more than 1 over 2. Q is more than 1 over 2 is this area, right? P equal to 1, it will look like this. So this is your P equal to 1 when for Q between 1, okay, Q more than half, right? Q more than a half, and then your P equal to 1. P equal to 1 is this line. So yeah, your P equal to 1 for this zone here. But your P will equal to 0 when Q is less than 1 over 2. Q is less than 1 over 2 is here, everyone. Q less than 1 over 2. So your P will equal to 0. It will be like this. And lastly, everyone, when your Q equal 1 over half, I mean, when Q equal to 1 half, it's this line here, right? Your P can be any value between 0 and 1. So I put a line there. Sorry, let me try again. Yes. Everyone, that's all I want to teach you. This is what we call the mixed strategy, Nash equilibrium. Yeah. This is when your P equal to 1 half and Q equal to 1 half. And why? I mean, what does this graph tell us? By the way, sorry, I forgot. this blue line is BR of P, right? So what we are doing right now is to find the best response of the two player to find the point that the best response of the two player are consistent. Everyone, we actually trying to solve for this one, right? We are trying to find the Nash equilibrium using this concept. We try to find the best response of one given what other player to, right? And it's, let's say it's consistent, as I told you earlier. We have a consistent best response between the two player. You are doing your best. I'm also doing my best. I mean, everyone is doing their best. So, and this is what this middle point is all about. It's the mixed strategy Nash equilibrium. It is, when player choose to play head and tail with 50% probability, we will have this Nash equilibrium. No one will want to deviate from this strategy here. Okay, no one will want to deviate from this strategy. And I guess that's the actually that's what I wrote in this. Here, you see, that's the conclusion. In matching penny, each player will play head with 50% prop and tail with 50% prop. So that's it, everyone. That's all of the mixed strategy Nash equilibrium. Thank you very much.